Yokohama was ranked 18th in 2014 in the Indigain Country Index rank. Yokohama is the second biggest city in Japan. Yokohama Tires originated from Yokohama and is located in Tokyo. Since last season, Yokohama has become one of the main sponsors for Chelsea's football club. There are various other sports that are sponsored, namely F1 local teams, 24-hour Le Mans racing, etc. The following stats were retrieved on the 1st of March 2016, the population of Yokohama being 3.7 million, of that females being 1.86 million, males being 1.85 million, 100 females is equal to 99.1 males, covers an area of 435.23 km squared with a density of 8.556 km squared, households being 1.6 million, with an average of 2.26 persons per household, an average annual growth rate of 1.07% for 2016. The Yokohama population growth doubled from 1960 to 1980, and the large-scale new towns were sprouting up and down the country without any control. The city experienced a shortage of housing, lack of green space, underdevelopment of schools, roads, and sewage systems. The residents adjacent to industrial areas suffered from noise and pollution. The environmental state of the city has improved dramatically. 50 years ago, the city was dominated by industrial pollution. Yokohama's next course of action is the development of countermeasures against global warming. In January 2008, the city launched CODO30, an action plan that aims to reduce per capita emissions of greenhouse gases by more than 30% by 2025. Undertaken ahead of efforts by the national government and other local governments, this novel initiative aims to cut CO2 emissions through the promotion of energy conservation at public facilities and by encouraging residents and businesses to adopt lifestyles and practices that reduce emissions of greenhouse gases. Yokohama further enlisted local businesses obtaining sponsorship funds for numerous enterprises to raise capital for operation and maintenance costs and for redemption of public bonds. These sponsoring enterprises are known as Y Green Partners. In April 2008, 8 governors and mayors from the Tokyo metropolitan area, as well as representatives from the region's business community, gathered in Yokohama to discuss the fight against global warming. The result was a joint declaration vowing to enhance collaboration in 3 areas: energy utilization, awareness building and environmental education, and international cooperation and assistance to developing countries. This initiative continues to expand each year. In 2007, about 23,000 elementary school students participated in the program and were supported by 75 of the city's companies. The donations raised were used in a tree planting project in the Republic of Guinea-Bissau. For the last 150 years, the city has also coped with natural disasters, war, and explosive population growth, making it only one of the few major cities in the world that have dealt with and overcome these challenges. Yokohama's Smart City Project, an initiative to establish overseas expansion of Japan's smart grid, was selected as a next generation energy infrastructure and social system demonstration area by the Ministry of Economy, Trade and Industry in April 2010. The city is in collaboration with the private sector, Accenture, Tokyo Gas, Toshiba, Nissan Motors, Panasonic, etc., to work on various projects such as introduction of renewable energy, energy management of households, buildings, and local communication and next transportation systems. Today, it ranks above average in terms of energy use and CO2 emissions, environmental land use and building regulations, sustainable transportation, waste management, air quality, and environmental governance. On the 11th of March 2011, a magnitude 9 earthquake shook northeastern Japan, unleashing a savage tsunami. The effects of the great earthquake were felt around the world, from Norway's fjords to Antarctica's ice sheets. Tsunami debris continues to wash up on North American beaches 2 years later. In Japan, residents are still recovering from the disaster. Radioactive water was recently discovered leaking from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, which suffered a level 7 nuclear meltdown after the tsunami. Japan relies on nuclear power, and many of the country's nuclear reactors remain closed because of stricter seismic safety standards since the earthquake. 4 years after the quake, about 230,000 people who lost their homes were still living in temporary housing. The number of confirmed deaths is 15,891 as of the 10th of April 2015, according to Japan's National Police Agency. Most people died by drowning. More than 2,500 people are still reported missing. Less than an hour after the quake, the first of many tsunami waves hit Japan's coastline. The tsunami wave reached run-up heights of up to 128 feet or 39 meters at Miyako City and traveled inland as far as 6 miles or 10 kilometers in Sendai. The tsunami flooded an estimated area of approximately 217 square miles or 561 square kilometers. The Indigene Country Index ranking for Japan was 18th in 2014. In the following, I will be talking about the vulnerability and readiness of Japan. Readiness measures a country's ability to leverage investments and convert them to adaptation actions. Indigene measures overall readiness by considering three components: economic readiness, governance readiness, and social readiness. Yokohama is the 16th most ready country. Vulnerability measures a country's exposure, sensitivity, and capacity to adapt to the negative effect of climate change. Indigene measures overall vulnerability by considering six life-supporting sectors: food, water, health, ecosystem service, human habitat, and infrastructure. Japan is the 26th least vulnerable country. The sustainability wedges consists of four categories: efficiency and conservation, fossil fuel, nuclear energy, and renewable and biostorage. If these four categories are followed or incorporated, then the country will become one that is sustainable and will have resources available for future generations. J-Power also owns Osaki Kugan, a 170 megawatt IGCC pilot plant near Hiroshima, where carbon capture but not storage will be demonstrated from 2019. Japan lacks suitable sites for storage and is concentrating on ways to reuse the carbon for enhanced oil recovery or production of algae for biofuel and fertilizer. Last year, Chiyoda and Euglena joined forces for Japan's first demonstration plant to produce and supply biojet biodiesel fuel. This plant will be constructed by Chiyoda specialists at the Yokohama seaside area as part of Euglena's plan towards 2020. On a tiny island in Japan's inland sea near Hiroshima, Osaki Kugan Corp. is building a $900 million experimental high-tech power station which turns coal into gas, generating steam to drive turbines. The plant under construction on Osaki Kamajima offers big reductions in carbon dioxide emissions. Solar and bioenergy are two major sources of renewable energy now used in Yokohama. Economic and regulatory measures were imposed or being considered, such as subsidies for the installation of solar water heaters and renewable energy uses targets in buildings at a certain size. The government aims to establish a designated entity called Yokohama Green Power to promote renewable energy. By the end of 2009, 2,945 units of solar power generation had been installed. One new energy initiative is the wind power station nicknamed Hama Wing, which began operating in April 2007. The Hama Wing is expected to produce approximately 3 million kilowatts of electricity per year, enough to cover the annual power consumption of about 860 households. It is calculated that this will result in a reduction of about 1,100 tons of CO2. The Hama Wing not only promotes the utilization of natural energy, it was also intended to spark concrete action by individual residents to help advance Yokohama's position as a city of environmental action. For this reason, the city did not invest taxpayers' money into the construction of the Hama Wing. Rather, it pushed the project forward with cooperation from citizens by issuing bonds open to purchase by residents. With 350 individuals making purchases, the bonds sold out in only 3 days. The city increased urban green areas by planting trees and promoting green rooftops or walls. Green areas are protected via the Urban Green Space Conservation Law, and finances required for conserving green areas are mobilized by levying a green tax and offering special treatment for fixed asset taxes in certain green areas. Projects were initiated in line with the achievement of the greenhouse gas emissions reduction and renewable energy use increase targets. One of these initiatives was the Yokohama Green Valley, which was started in 2010. Apart from the government's efforts to green existing businesses by reforming financial institutions to favor green businesses and by operating carbon offsetting sponsored by the city government, the project of the Yokohama Green Valley aims to form clusters consisting of businesses, factories, and public facilities in a compact manner. The purpose of the project is to boost green innovation and to commercialize green technologies. Included in an energy monitoring project, an electric vehicle sharing project, and an environmental education program in collaboration with the universities in the city. The city is also enthusiastically adopting green energies to encourage a shift away from fossil fuels. Natural gas prices are low. Gas storage levels are at an all-time high. Factors in the Clean Power Plan, finalized in August, aimed at cutting carbon pollution from power plants, and it's clear to see that natural gas is poised to take even more power generation market share away from coal in 2016. There are 38 known power plants in Japan with a fuel type of natural gas. 2,000 individuals protested against nuclear power in Yokohama. The 11th of March 2011, the disasters of the earthquake, tsunami, and related meltdowns of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, as mentioned before, has led to great suffering of the people of Japan and has increased radioactivity contamination against the globe. This could also mean that if Yokohama had nuclear power, then the environment and individuals would be at less of a risk than with gas. In order for Yokohama to be a low carbon city, it's important that the transportation sector, contributing to about 20% of the CO2 output, becomes low carbon. It is important for traffic vehicles themselves, including automobiles and railway, to become low carbon, and for all those involved to cooperate in a comprehensive manner to put in low carbon traffic infrastructure and increase awareness amongst those who use transportation. As a municipality bearing traffic and environment administration responsibilities, Yokohama is active in areas including deployment of EVs and subsidizing charging facilities, promoting of railway projects and public transportation usage, and popularization and education of eco-driving. The quality of public transport, a community-wide bicycle scheme, and promoting electric vehicles were put into place. At the end of 2019, 10 chargers and 34 electric vehicles have been introduced. Urban transit railways were quickly installed to accommodate the urban sprawl and various modes of public transport, such as subway, light rail, bus, and cycling, were coordinated. The Yokohama City administrators took the initiative to adopt low carbon measures such as retrofitting public facilities, installing rainwater harvesting systems, monitoring energy consumption and CO2 emissions through information technologies, and installation of solar power generators. These actions not only helped reduce CO2 emissions from the public sector, but also disseminated good practices to the public. Deploying of wind energy to generate hydrogen for all fleets of zero emission electric vehicles efficiently. Recently, there have been several developments leading to the realization and expansion of the use of biofuels, such as renewable jet fuel in Japan. In July last year, the establishment of the committee of the study of a process leading to introduction of renewable jet fuel for the 2020 Summer Olympic and Paralympic Games in Tokyo by the Minister of Economy, Trade and Industry and Ministry of Land, Infrastructure, Transport and Tourism was an important step towards the use of renewable materials in the country. By addressing environmental issues and voluntarily practicing environmental stewardship, the country can prove that it is determined to pursue the realization of a sustainable society and to move forward with concrete community-based environmental actions. Once Yokohama has achieved their goal for becoming a full eco-city, they will be monitoring and verifying it. Thank you very much.